Then you know that I believe I'm going mad, or worse.
Oh, Dr. Watson will bear me out, Count Romany, when I tell you that people who really are on the verge of insanity never think it of themselves.
I dreamt of brightly colored corridors, their length stretched endlessly into the distance, their walls echoing strange and worldly music. In my dream, I hurried from empty room to empty room, through floods of brilliant, very colored light. I saw no people, no living things, only the rooms of red, gold, and jet, and sapphire and emerald. At times, the music seemed to be far away, thin and cold, as though coming from the depths of interstellar space. And then again, it would seem so near that I was certain I would find its source in the next room that I entered.
Verily, it shall this day, and the bones of my ancestors topple down the floor is true. I consulted doctors. They gave me pills to make me sleep, when sleep was the one thing I dreaded. The local priests spoke learnedly of exorcism and possession by the devil, but they could not prevent my dream. The servants have run away in superstitious fear.
Mr. Holmes, am I mad? Tell me, am I mad?
Or am I cursed by that
fearful family tree?
All that.
Tell you at the moment, Count Romany. But the priest was not mistaken when he said
the devil has been
here.
The
Deny, but
my dreams,
the depths of the dark,
burial vault,
the haunted get that girl?
I'm not offering a riddle, Watson.
But it's solution.
Your dreams come from when you had one creature which immediately led me to suspect their unnatural origin. You spoke of ringing currents, of unearthly music, of a distorted sense of space and time. Characteristics of the dreams, or more properly, visions induced by the drug cannabis indica, more commonly known as hashish. And since you showed none of the signs of a habitual drug taker, it was at once apparent to me that your dreams were being induced by someone who administered the drug to you in your food or wine on those occasions when they desired you to have one of your hallucinations.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
That's a very attractive spring hat you're wearing, Marya.
Like it?
Yes, very much. But how about removing it so we can see those lovely shining locks?
Why, of course. I'd love to.
Marya, your hair certainly looks like $1,000,000.
Thanks to you, Mr. Powers.
To me?
Yes. The first advice you gave me when I became a Powers model was to always wash my hair with Cremel shampoo. And I must say, never in my life have I used any shampoo that left my hair more radiant.
Yes, I'm completely sold on Cremel shampoo. You see, Cremel shampoo has been especially developed to glamour bathe each tiny strand of hair to reveal all its natural brilliant luster.
And don't forget to mention the built-in oil base.
That's what helps keep the hair from becoming dry and brittle. The Powers girls tell me that after Cremel shampoo, their hair holds a wave and curl much better. In fact, I certainly recommend Cremel shampoo, not only to the Powers girls, but to every woman who wants to bring out the radiant, shining beauty in her hair.
This is ABC, the American Broadcasting Company.